In this overview, which is part of a series, we'll show you where to find some of the most commonly used administrative features in the Simplified interface. Whether you're a new user or moving from the standard workspace, this will ease your transition, orient you, and help you get started. We'll outline how to find and manage dimensions and members, jobs, EPM Automate, approvals, application settings, audit, financial reporting, and where to perform common administrative tasks. Videos about many of these features are on the Help Center. We'll also show you how to learn about what's new in each update. Functionally streamlined and easy to use, the Simplified interface provides quick access to your tasks, analyses, and data. You can access this content using the Navigator too. You can also use the Navigator to define business objects such as forms, business rules, smart lists, tasks, and variables, and to access common capabilities such as data management. To work with your metadata and data, select Application, Overview, and then Dimensions. Here, you can create dimensions and members, edit member properties, and import and export dimensions, data, and exchange rates by file using the provided templates for guidance. You can schedule many of these tasks as jobs. To schedule one-time or recurring jobs, select Application, then Jobs. Here, you can define jobs for tasks such as import data, run business rules, and identify invalid dimension combinations. Service administrators can use EPM Automate to remotely perform task routines on cloud clients, such as importing and exporting data and backing up application snapshots. To get started, download EPM Automate from the home page, install, launch the utility from your Start menu, and use the login command with your service administrator credentials to sign into an environment. Note that single sign-on credentials cannot be used. Enter EPM Automate Help for information about all commands. Although you define planning units and their hierarchy in the standard workspace, use the Approvals card to review and take action on the plans that approval units have submitted. For example, you can delegate to reassign approval units or promote approval units with acceptable plans to pass them to the next reviewer. To modify application settings, select Application, then Settings. You can specify options such as number formatting, notifications, and aliases. You can also revert to the defaults. Service administrators can enable audit tracking by selecting Tools, Audit, Enable Auditing, Data, and then Refresh. This tracks changes by time frame and user to data such as cell values, cell level documents, account annotations, and supporting detail. You can export audit reports to Microsoft Excel. Service administrators and power users can author multi-dimensional reports and graphs with Financial Reporting Web Studio, a similar alternative to the Windows-based client. The Web Studio provides enhanced usability and new design paradigms. You can edit reports in either studio and add reports to dynamic books. To get started, download Financial Reporting from the homepage and install. To design reports, launch the studio from the Navigator. To view and print reports, use the Reports card. You can perform most administrative tasks using the Application card. For example, on Overview, you can view application artifacts and properties, manage cubes, refresh the database, and delete applications. On Data Maps, you can leverage metadata between sources and targets to perform tasks such as linking data to multiple reporting applications. To review what's provided in any update, use the Enterprise Performance Management Readiness page. Access this page using this URL or using Learn More on the Getting Started Help Center page. In this overview, we showed you where to perform key tasks in the Simplified interface.
Look out for the next video to learn about capabilities such as dashboards, forms, and custom navigation flows.
To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.